Hello, you all. Welcome to the channel. Welcome to Radko Tarot. It's Rad, and in this whole video, we're going to look into Scorpio Sun, Moon, and as well Rising. Their week, our week, for I am Scorpio as well, December 21st to December 27th, 2020. And for those who doesn't know, there is a flash sale on the tarot classes which I am providing. It's exclusive for the Facebook following, and they can get the minor arcana tarot class on 50% of the price and the major arcana tarot class on a 35% of the price. And in order to get the sale, guys, you just have to go to my Facebook page, click like, and send me a message on the Facebook page messages. I'm going to provide you with a link for the where you can purchase the tarot classes on a reduced price. So with that being said, let's see what awaits us, shall we? First one we have, which is the topic of the week for Scorpio, that is going to be the Chariot. Moving next, we do have the energies which are feeding and supporting the topic here. That will be the Fool, followed by the challenges that we need to overcome throughout the week. That is going to be the Hierophant. Afterwards, we do have the gifts and the blessings that we get to enjoy throughout the week. That is going to be the Four of Wands. Then it is the impression of the people around, and what the people are going to see when they look at us. That is going to be the Star card. Afterwards, it is the obstacles which are going to hold us back and down. That is going to be the Ten of Cups. Next, we do have the positive aspects which are going to make us push forward. That is going to be the Five of Pentacles. And the last one here we have, that will be the guidance the Tarot is offering. We have the Knight of Pentacles. Right. We are talking about some kind of a new beginning, some kind of an entering into a new era here with those cards. Personally, I don't see how this is about to happen to me, but I'm pre-recording the video a week beforehand, so you never know. I mean, I had it a few times where my life just changed like that. One day was something, and then at the other day at the morning, totally different, okay? So you never know. That's a funny thing, you know. You get to know your future, but you don't get to understand it. And this is what kind of like most people want to understand it rather than to know it. In any case, let's check on the first couple of cards here. We do have the Fool, which is the energy of the week, followed by, which is forcing the topic. And this is a typical, how can I say, a typical standpoint here for throughout the week, where you're going to start feeling that we do need a fresh start. In many fields, these are the energies. The Fool's energy is where we guys are feeling that we have to deal with stuff, or rather like start doing things spontaneously, with a lack of concern what happens afterwards, okay? We will feel the need to associate with people that doesn't make us feel bad, guilty, any way emotionally attached. So these energies are gonna make us feel unattached to the seriousness of life, and that is gonna make us foresee, or rather like wanting to pretty much have a fresh start, like a new relationship, for example, like a new job, for example. This is what we are gonna feel we need. And once that feeling is established and the need is identified here with the Fool card, then the real topic kicks in, which is the topic of the Chariot card. And the topic of the Chariot card kind of points to our presence, our personal standing in the world, that we actually can do the job, that we can experience the luck of our hard work, that we can accomplish a wish fulfillment, that we are proud of ourselves, that we are attractive, that we are capable, and so on and so forth. It's all about we, us, okay? And that is going to bring to highly boosted, probably this far, very neglected a personal self-esteem. And the week itself is going to be something like a preparation for a huge leap into development afterwards. It's like gathering up a momentum. And after that, jumping either a relationship, either into a new relationship, or either into a new job, or maybe both. If that's a change, entirely new beginning, restarting of a one's life. Moving next, we do have the challenges that we need to overcome here, and that is going to be the Hierophant. And oh my, these are, at least to me, these are going to be very difficult challenges, because the Hierophant here as a challenge points that we have to break the walls that our beliefs are restricting us under, okay? For example, we do believe that we have to live at a certain place in order to be happy. We have to break that belief and kind of like widen our horizon, that we can be happy regardless where we live, or that we can be happy just only with that person, but we can be happy with any kind of person for as long as that person is nurturing us, it respects us, okay, it has trust in us, it gives us freedom, and so on and so forth. So with the Hierophant here, the challenge is so forth to kind of like expand on the framework of our life, if I can say it that way, and realize that life can be so much more colorful than it is at that given moment. That we should not work for money, but we should work for the work itself. Money are gonna find us on their own accord, right? We should not be with a person just because, you know, we do have an emotions toward them, or just because we like them, but we should be with that person, for example, because we can trust them, you know, because they make us, like I said, feel free. And it's just, the challenge here is completely to rebuild our beliefs, our criterias, and in generally our code of conduct. And that is going to be very difficult because we are going to be very vulnerable in this week or people are going to see us very vulnerable this week and very predisposed to follow certain guides, whether they are a good guide or a bad guide. In other words, everybody will think that they can pretty much tell us what we should do, and that they couldn't be more wrong than that, okay? So for that reason, we can expect to kind of like, you know, break ties with certain people into our life that are trying to establish control over our life on our expense. The Fool as the energy, it's a free soul, free spirit. It is the acme of freedom. Nobody can tell us what we should do in this week. We have to find it for ourselves. And then we do have the gifts and the blessings that we get to enjoy. And that will be the Four of Wands, which is very fitable for the narrative of the reading. Four of Wands in this particular case points that we are gifted with the momentum. Four of Wands, it is like a magic circle in this case, okay? That an energy gathers up in that circle, and we get to decide where we are going to open the circle and what direction we are going to point that energy into. The magic circle predispose, or rather like signifies a successful accomplishment of cycles of development. We simply are better than, for example, a few months ago. We simply are more sensible. We simply are more determined, and so on and so forth. We have taken under consideration the important details we had missed up until this point. And now we know our direction. Now we know what we want. Now we know where we should go. Now we know whom we should be happy with. Now we know what job we are going to recognize as our calling, and so on and so forth. So as a gift here, we are gifted with a milestone, a lifetime milestone, that from it, there is no going back, and thank God, you know. But on a more practical level here, Scorpio, we are gifted with really pleasant time. There could be some kind of a celebrations. I even have scheduled, to visit my parents that week. So yeah, I mean, it's Christmas as well, now that I think of. So yeah, we are going to enjoy the celebrations, should we celebrate. Moving next, we do have the impression of those around us, what kind of people are going to see when they look at us. That is going to be the star card. People are going to see us happy. There is no other way to say it here. People are going to see us. Finally, we are actually chasing something that we can say it's ours, that we are finally moving into the path that we have wanted to move into for very, very long time ago. People see us very unyielding in terms of our criteria, in terms of our standards. And some of the people may, when they look at us, they may see us that we are ready to give love into the world. So yeah, some of those that are around us may recognize us as a potential suitor and a potential partner. There is nothing wrong with that. The question is, does we recognize them as such? Okay, because this card is about how people see us, not how we see them, okay? So moving next, we do have the obstacles which are going to hold us back and down, and that is the Ten of Cups. And that's an obstacle, all right? At least to me it's going to be, because I'm happy. And restarting even one field of one's life predisposed that things are not going to be as they are right now, okay? And we may kind of like feel reluctant and even think reluctantly to change anything into our environment, as we are finding ourselves happy as it stands. So why we should change anything, right? But this is life, guys. And I am talking to myself right now. This is life, Rad. Life is about constant movement. It's about constant improvement. And that is a side of the human nature that no matter how much you have, you always should go for more. For we as a human beings, we always seek evolution, improvement. Simply, we always polish, learn, and we always get better. That's what the card here points, that we need to look outside of our domain and do at least a tiny steps, a tiny efforts to pretty much leave a little bit our zone of comfort, so we can see that we can be happy with even more than it is right now. Moving next, we do have the positive aspects which are going to help us push forward. That is the Five of Pentacles. So this is a very practical card that we do have here. We are going to find solution to many of our concerns and our problems in that particular week, December 21st to December 27th. And yeah, I do have a pretty severe concern right now. Nothing major, nothing life-threatening, all right? But it's quite severe. And probably on Monday, I'm going to see what kind of a measures I will have to take in regards to it. But other than that, with the Five of Pentacles, we are going to address the aspects of our life, where which aspects are making us feel uncertain, insecure, and as well, in generally, are not making us feel good. And by addressing those aspects, we are going to find solution as well. Another thing about the Five of Pentacles, it is that we does not have to face those problems alone, okay? There is somebody that it's either a faithful companion of ours, or it is within a similar situation as we are, and they are willing to help. So don't be proud, Scorpio, to ask for help should help wants to come on its own accord. And the last card we have, which is the guidance the Tarot is offering, that is the King of Pentacles, the Knight of Pentacles, I'm sorry. So we do have the Knight of Pentacles. And oh my, first things first with the Knight of Pentacles, guys. We as Scorpio, we should not be hectic or chaotic moving forward. But instead, we should be very systematic and consistent. That is something I am repeating to myself constantly. I need to be consistent. Unfortunately, that's a lesson that I am learning now, 5 years maybe, but I cannot get it right. So hopefully this week is going to make me learn how to do it right. I have taken measures already. But that's one thing, being consistent. Keep the things in KISS principle. Keep it simple and stupid with whatever you are to deal with. And the last thing here, Knights of Pentacles in terms of guidance urges us to, play out in a few ways, but in generally, if we're talking about emotional connection, Knights of Pentacles points that if there is somebody new that comes about that shows interest, we should give it a go. Or the other thing here about the Knights of Pentacles, it is that if an ex comes about, we should give it a go as well. So yeah, that being said, Scorpio, this was our weekly general tarot reading, December 21st to December 27, 2020. Hopefully you do enjoy it just as much as I did, guys, and we are to see each other next time. Until then, bye.